Welcome to another episode of Kitchen Revelations. So today we are going to learn how to make instant oat dosa. This can be an ideal breakfast, lunch or dinner option for all those who are suffering from thyroid, PCOS or in your simple weight loss journey. Most of them face difficulty in preventing the oats dosa batter from sticking to the pan. Watch till the end to learn how to make a non-sticky oats dosa batter. Into a bowl, add 1 cup of rolled oats. Add enough water to soak the oats. Soaking oats will help in release the phytic acid content in oats. Phytic acid prevents nutrient absorption, hence it is necessary that you soak oats before consumption. You need to soak oats for just 15 minutes, but if you don't have time in the morning, you can also soak it overnight. So after about 15 minutes, you can see that the oats has puffed up really well. If you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon next to it for regular updates. Click on the all option so that you get updates as and when I post. Next, take a mixer grinder jar and add the soaked oats into this jar. Next is a secret ingredient. These are shallots. They help in preventing the dosa from sticking onto the pan. They're also rich in iron and folate, which helps in increasing the health quotient of this recipe. If you don't have shallots, you can also use onion in this recipe. Next, I'm going to add 1-inch piece of roughly chopped ginger, 1 green chili and few curry leaves. Finally, grind this into a smooth batter. Add very little water while grinding if required. Since my grinder jar is small, I've ground it in 2 batches. If you have a larger one, you can grind it all together. So you can see that the batter is of pourable consistency, that is dosa batter consistency. If it is really thick, you can add in a little bit more water. Now to this, I'll be adding 1/4 teaspoon of pink Himalayan salt. Mix this really well and keep it aside. Meanwhile, we will start with the cooking process. Now just before cooking, I'll be adding 1 tablespoon of rava. This will give nice crispy texture to your dosas. Please ensure that when you cook oats dosa, the flame should be on low, else you will not be able to spread the batter evenly. Pour in 1 teaspoon of any healthy fat. Here I've used ghee. To make crisp dosas, increase the flame to medium and cook till they turn crispy. Once crisp, remove them onto a plate. You can serve this with tomato chutney or coconut chutney or any chutney of your choice. I'll give you a closer look of how soft and crispy the oats dosas are. I hope you all like this video. If you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Also, please do share your feedback in the comment section below. Thank you for watching Kitchen Revelations.